Hi, AT from CNC at home. I was talking with my mom, and she said that she had this medallion and was wondering if I could do some engraving on the back. So here's the medallion, and on the back there's a clear spot or clear area. So I'm going to put that on the 3018 router and see if we can do a little engraving with that. I'm going to use a program called Engrave to create the G-code to engrave the back of this medallion. So the first thing that we do is we'll type in what we want to engrave on the back. So I come down here to the text input, and I'm going to put BJ space JS. Then on the next line, I'm going to put 82920. All right, so up here on the justify, I'm going to have this centered. And I'm also going to center this, I'm going to put the origin for this in the center. So right here in the middle, that's where my zero is going to be for this. I don't like that font. Let's change the font here. Oh, no, that's not what I want to do. There's a setting for that somewhere. No, it's, I bet it's here. There we go. Maybe it's up here. There's an aerial round that I want to use. There we go. Yeah, that one works well because it has rounded corners. It's a little less work for something small to try and get those nice sharp corners. So on a bigger font, yeah, that's kind of a cool way you can do stuff. But when it's going to be small like this, it doesn't work so well. Okay, so if we look down here at the bottom, this is going to be 329 millimeters by 107, which is way too big. We have about 16 to 18 millimeters of working area on here. We could maybe squeeze out 18. So 16 is a safe amount. 17 would be about the max. So somewhere about there for the width. So we're going to need to make the text a lot smaller. So I'm going to use 3 millimeter, which I know is kind of small. We'll do a recalc here. Now that's saying it's 19.5, but look at the space in here. The character spacing is way too big. So let's set that down to 5%. See what that gets us. Now we're at 15.2. So that looks pretty good. And I want a little more space in the line here. There we go. Separate that. Okay, over here with the feed rate, I found that 200 millimeters per minute seems to work fairly well. I don't need to go quite that high on my safe zone. I'll put in a 2 millimeters on the safe zone, so I don't waste a lot of time moving up and down. Okay, so this looks good. So we've got 3 millimeter 110. Okay, and then in our settings, let's go to our V car. We've got a 20 degree V bit. This is wrong. It's 3.175. And we're going to go negative 0.5. That's the limit to how deep this is going to cut, so we don't want to go very deep. So just a half a millimeter. Keep stepping. Don't do any of that. We're not going to use that. Clean up steps. Okay, that looks good. So let's go ahead and calculate. So we'll see over here what it's going to do for us. Okay, and all of this gray area inside of the letters and numbers, that's what needs to get cleaned up. So we're going to run the cleanup, which will, we're just using the V-bit cleanup because I have the other bit turned off. And we'll just do X and Y. So all this yellow is where that V bit will go through and just hog out the extra material. So we'll go ahead and click save. Save that. Yes, I want to replace. Okay, and we'll close the settings and then we'll come to our file. We'll click save. And again, I'd already saved this one before, so we'll click save on that. Yep, so we'll replace it. And that should be all we need to do. So the next step is to just put that into our sender and send that onto the router. After we've centered everything up, we should be set to go.
One of the first things we're going to need to figure out is how to clamp this down. It's got some texture or height on the front here. So you can see it sits flat on the back, but that's where we need to do our engraving. So it doesn't sit flat here, so we need to create a little fixture for that. I have just the thing. Okay, here it is. What I did was I just took a piece of wood that I had, and I took a Forstner bit that was just slightly smaller than the diameter of the medallion. Turns out that the medallion is over 1 inch in size, so I was able to take a 1 inch Forstner bit, create a nice little pocket in here, and the medallion sits in here nicely. So I think what I'll do is grab a couple clamps and see if we can secure that. Okay, these are the clamps that I'm going to use. They are a bit on the large side, and they will clamp this nicely. So let's get that set up and see what it looks like. That seems to clamp in nicely. The medallion seems to be secure in there. Just get in close. You can kind of see how that's done. It's just grabbing on the edge. I have these two clamps holding that in, and this piece of wood works nicely for that.
Well, it turns out we had multiple problems here. One was the clamps weren't holding as well as it should. I cut too deep, and as you can see on the 8 over on the left and the top of the 2, it actually went all the way through the medallion. So this one's pretty much ruined. I do have another medallion that I was using for testing to get my feeds and speeds. And that one didn't turn out so well, but I just put the BJS up on top. I only cut a half a millimeter deep, did the cleanup, and that turned out really nicely. So I wish I could go back and do another one, but I don't have another blank. You can see a mistake on this one too at the bottom of the J, where I moved the bit while it was spinning and it wasn't out of the material. Here's the comparison between the two.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.